In 2021, I was struggling as a freelance designer, charging $500 per project and constantly hustling for clients. Today, I run a profitable Webflow business, charging more than $5,000 per project. But here's what's interesting. I'm not working more hours. I'm actually working less. So if you're watching this, you're probably tired of low-paying projects, you're overwhelmed by the competition, you're unsure how to even find clients, or you're just starting and don't even know where to begin. In this video, I show you exactly how you can build your own profitable Webflow business in 2025. No fluff, no theory, just the exact steps that I use and how you can replicate them. First, let's talk about why Webflow and why now. Webflow isn't just another website builder. Here's what makes it different. There's been a lot of growth from large companies moving to Webflow, which also means that the demand for Webflow experts is growing and growing. And the fact that these are big companies also means that you can charge premium rates because they have a lot more budget. Also, as you may know, Webflow has a bit of a learning curve, but that's actually a good thing because it keeps the casual competition away and it leaves more room for us that are experts that really focus on this one thing. And the timing now is actually perfect, because a lot of companies are moving away from WordPress because it's too outdated. And also the no-code movement is exploding. You see this in tools like Framer, Reloom, and so on. And there's more and more tools where you don't need complicated coding experience. And it feels like Webflow is on the road on becoming the number one way to make a website, which is even a more reason to get into it now. Now, what do you actually need to start? So first, you need basic design skills. You don't need to be the best designer out there, but you need a basic understanding of color, typography, and layouts. You also need a basic understanding of web fundamentals. You don't need to be super proficient, but if you have no skills in this area, don't worry. I'll leave some links in the description you can check out and brush up on all the fundamentals that you need to learn. So third thing you need, this is super obvious, but you of course need a computer and internet. Doesn't need to be a good computer, you don't need the best internet also, so just the basics. And now the last thing you need, and this is super important, you need 2 to 3 months to learn Webflow properly. And so here's a realistic timeline that you can follow along. Month 1 is just learning Webflow. Month 2 is building your portfolio. Month 3 is landing your first client. And then after that, month 4 to 6 is scaling up all the way to projects that are worth $5,000 or more. So let's get practical. Here's exactly what you need to do first. And a lot of beginner designers make the mistake of including too many random projects that don't really tell a story. At the start, you should aim to create 3 strategic portfolio pieces. Let's say 1 landing page, 1 multi-page site, and 1 more complex feature showcase. Now, next up, you really need to think about how you want to price your services. You can start with this simple framework. Discovery sessions for $500, landing pages for $2,000, and more complex full websites for $4,000 or $5,000. We can also offer ongoing support for your websites, which I would price at around $400 to $500 per month. And after that, you need to think about your service packages. At the beginning, start really simple. You can create 3 tiers. Essential is just a basic website. Professional is the website and extras, for example, SEO setup or analytics setup or something like that. And then the enterprise tier is the full service where you offer everything that you have, SEO setup, Webflow client training, and so on and so on. Everything that you can think of to really maximize the value you give to your client. The key here is positioning. You're not selling websites, you're selling business results. If you want to dive deeper on the offer creation part, I can highly recommend the book $100 Million Offers by Alex Hormozi, so go check it out. Now this is the part you've been waiting for, actually getting clients. So to do this, quickly think about your ideal client profile. And so these are my ideal client characteristics, and you can just copy them if you want or make your own. So I mainly go for B2B companies because in my past experiences, it has been easier to deal with them. And the next thing I look out for in my client profile is they need to be established businesses with more than 2 years of being in business, because otherwise the projects can be really risky. You don't know if they will even exist anymore after the project, and it's just not a really sustainable way of finding clients. And for me, what's also important is they need to have a clear service or product, because there are some companies, they make 800 different products and they don't even know themselves what they do. So I really look for these companies that have really niched down their offerings. And also important here, super important, you need to have an existing marketing budget, and the budget needs to be high enough so that they can obviously pay the project. And so you might ask, how should I know how big the marketing budget is? I can't see inside their finances. And so yes, you're right, you can't see into their finances, but there's a really quick hack that I like to do, which lets you calculate their approximate marketing budget. This is really quick, don't worry, you don't need to be a math genius. So what you need to do is you need to find out how many employees a company has, and you just take the number of employees, let's say 10 employees in this case, and you multiply them by 100,000, because this is approximately the cost of an employee per year. So that would make $1 million, and that means they need to bring in $1 million per year in revenue, otherwise their business would go extinct. And then you divide this 1 million by 10, and you get their approximate marketing budget. So 1 million divided by 10 is obviously 100,000. Their total marketing budget is somewhere around 100,000 per year. But we will again divide this by 10 because they won't spend their whole marketing budget for a year on just a website. They have other things, they need to run ads and so on. So we divide it again by 10, and that leaves us with $10,000 for a website, which is pretty reasonable, I think. And so you can use this hack as kind of a guideline to know how much you can charge your clients. And so where to actually find these people? And so I've outlined four places where you can actually find them. The first one is LinkedIn, but this also applies for other social media like X or Facebook. And I will show you my outreach method in a second. The second one is often overlooked, but it's your personal network, so your friends, your family, and everything that you know, basically, which can be a very powerful way to find clients. The third one is industry-specific forums, so events, festivals, and everywhere where you can meet people in person. And the fourth one is also super powerful, and it's the Webflow Marketplace. This one is only for Webflow experts, but I've made a complete video that you can watch after this if you want to learn how you can become a Webflow expert. And so you might be wondering, well, how does this exactly work in practice? So let me show you an example how you can reach out to potential clients on social media, for example. Don't do it like this. Hey, I'm a Webflow designer looking for clients, blah, blah, blah. Instead, do this. Hi, I noticed you're in this industry. I'm really impressed with this specific thing about your business. I had some thoughts about your website's conversion rate based on my experiences with similar companies in your space. This immediately sets the stage and positions you as a valuable expert. Then of course you wait for their response.
6.5 hours later.
And then you can answer something like this. Would you be open to a 15-minute call where I can show you other industry companies that have solved these exact issues? And then only after they show interest, of course, you can send them your calendar link and set up the call. Now, once they're interested, you can have a sales call with them, and to dive into all the specifics of the sales call would be a little bit too much for this video, but I will give you a very simple outline that you can follow for your own sales process. So the first thing you need to prepare is your discovery call script where you can riff off of. So the second thing you need is you need to prepare a proposal template that you can send after the sales call. And then the third thing you need to have in place is a follow-up system. You can automate this with email and so that your potential client don't think that you've forgotten about them. And the fourth thing you need is you have some kind of closing technique. So this can happen again over the phone. And then when the client is really wanting to move forward, you close them on the phone and you have a new project. So once you have your first client, here's how to scale. First up, you need some kind of client onboarding. Let's say, for example, you sign on a new client. You need to onboard them. You need them to give them all the relevant information. And the next up, you need some kind of project management. A lot of people use Notion for this. For me, I feel like it's a little bit too complicated. I don't know. I'm not a big fan of project management in Notion. I rather use Trello because it's very straightforward and it's very simple to use for you and your client. You can just create cards and it's very intuitive. And then next up, you need some kind of communication flow. You need to do virtual calls. Maybe I use Microsoft Teams for this. You can also use Slack for like instant communication. Also email is fine. You don't need to overcomplicate this. Just pick the tool that works best for you. And then you also need some kind of delivery process where you will send them all the files, like some kind of Dropbox link or WeTransfer or even in Notion. A Notion dashboard can also work fine. I mostly do it with WeTransfer links when I need to send stuff to my clients because it's very simple and easy to use again. And most of the clients know it anyway now, so they trust the link. And now some common pitfalls to avoid. Number one, never overpromise, because this can really backfire very quickly. If the client asks you, for example, if you can build a complex web app in React, for example, and you've never coded in your life, then obviously it's a stupid idea to say, yeah, of course, I can build it for you, because of course you can learn it, but the risk of failure is very high. And let's say, for example, this is like a big guy in your town and he tells all the people that you did a terrible job. It will be a lot harder to find clients from now on if everyone knows that you overpromise stuff. And now the second one, I still struggle with this sometimes, is poor time management. And now after a while, after you get some experience, you will know how long certain things take to build, like how long a landing page takes you, how long a multi-page takes you. And so take these insights to improve your processes and know how you need to plan forward. And now the third pitfall to avoid is to have unclear boundaries. And this often happens when you're really desperate to please your client and the client comes to you and says, oh, can you do this and this and this and this? And it's a lot more than you agreed on. It's really not a healthy practice. Maybe in the short term, the client will thank you, but in the long term, he will lose respect because you didn't set any boundaries and you will just continue to walk over you. If you already got your first couple of clients and now you want to really scale up, I recommend you to do the following couple of things. You need to document everything to improve your processes and also create templates so you can become quicker and quicker, which really I love and really saves me a lot of time in my daily work. So then you can also build referral systems. So you go to a happy client and tell them that if they refer you, they get maybe 10% commission on the project or something like that. And then last but not least, continue to improve and learn from your failures. So to wrap this up, here are your couple next steps that you need to take. Remember, success doesn't happen overnight, but following this system will get you there way faster than if you were to figure it out all alone. First, start with your Webflow certification. I will provide helpful links in the description so you can get started right away. Second, build your first portfolio piece. I will also leave descriptions for you in the comments for some inspirations that you can use. And third, set up your service packages. I highly recommend checking out the books .com Secrets and $100 million offers. I will also leave links down in the description if you want to check it out. Also, don't forget to subscribe if you found this content valuable, and I will see you in the next one.